on this week's Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine. Bob takes a pre-Christmas trip to sunny Miami, Florida for some peacock fishing. Joining Bob will be Roger Gonzalez with iOutdoor Adventures. And on this week's Sportsman's Table, we do a different twist on a South Carolina certified tuna salad. All this and a whole lot more. It begins right now.
Woo! Oh, beautiful. Oh, huh? There we go, perfect. Nice.
That's what I come down here for.
Ha ha! Woohoo! Awesome.
Mmm. You got a pretty good largemouth there.
Yeah, there you go. Oh yeah, that's it. Mmm. Now talk to me a little bit. Now, the peacocks are in here as well as largemouth?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
For being a native fish, yeah, oh, they're
yeah.
here too.
That's a nice largemouth right there. Mmm. Mmm. Nice.
There
nice.
You go.
Get him.
Oh,
get
there's
him,
one.
Get him.
Oh, come on, be a big one. Oh
big
yeah, baby.
Oh wow.
Feels pretty good.
Okay. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh Lord. There we go. Come on, baby.
Woo-hoo.
Feels
get
pretty
him.
Good.
Get him, Roger.
Feels pretty good.
You got him. You need some help.
Another peacock. There you go.
Hang on a minute. Let me get down here.
I need some help. Bob.
I work for peanuts, man.
There you
oh,
go.
Oh, yeah. Nice peacock. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Pretty colors.
There you go, Bob.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Wow. Awesome.
You're the man.
Awesome. I'll tell you what, he wasn't getting away. You had him.
He's thick.
Yeah, he is. Nice.
Beautiful color.
Beautiful
colors,
spot, beautiful yep. colors. Look at that.
You know the reason on that spot on the tail? In the Amazon, there's freshwater dolphins, so they develop this nature. On this fish develop this so instead of be attacked through the front,
right.
It looks like the second eye so they can get away from the dolphins. Yep.
Oh, okay.
It's like a camouflage so they won't get eaten.
Mm. Listen, that is the most believable story I believe I've heard
well,
in a long time, Bobby.
I studied for that. Let me tell you one thing. I had to read a book
that
about
it. That was a test question. Okay.
There you go.
Oh, man. I'm feeling it, brother.
Got a bite?
He's pecking.
Got it. There
got
you
it.
Go.
Got it.
I'm getting bit too.
All right.
There's a fish. We got another double, baby.
It must be down here in this, must be in this hole down here
yep.
or something. Huh? You got
there's
it?
A bunch of rocks down here. Yeah, I
yeah.
got them.
Okay.
There's a bunch of rocks in deep water. That's
yeah,
where they're sitting
I got
at.
Well, and it makes a big difference too. You know? Makes a big difference.
Mine is hung up or something. Yep. It's coming up. I think I'm getting the whole tree coming up too. It's probably a brush pile down there.
Well,
here he comes. There he comes.
You got it? Okay.
Yep.
All right, man. Let's get him right where they can
there
see
you. There you go.
All right. Come on. All right. They're Hollywood fish, man. Hollywood. Hollywood.
Damn, pretty, buddy.
Yeah, beautiful.
They're
aren't they?
Lovely
look at
fish.
Wow.
Look at the colors on this fish, buddy.
Okay. Now, how did you get started? You came over to the United States to play baseball?
Actually, I was born here, but I grew up in South America in 96. That was when I started, you know, playing ball.
Right.
That's when I first came up here to the United States. Believe it or not, that I born here. I never been here before that time. So, you know, it was a tough career through a lot of injuries. But thank God now I'm fishing, man. And
that's all that matters.
Oh, it only
yeah,
matters.
You. And you're good at that, too. Okay.
Well,
yeah.
I was better at baseball, to be honest with you. Thank you, baby.
Yeah. All right. Man, that's great. That's awesome. You know, doubles. Huh? I know
you're the man, buddy.
That.
You're all the right. man. I told you if he's not here, he's not going to be nowhere. We got the peacocks going, baby.
All right, man.
Get ready, buddy. Throw them in there.
All right. I'm going.
Get ready. They're all over now.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah.
Get him, man.
God, Lord.
Man, there's
thank
always
you, baby.
Enthusiasm, man.
I'm telling you, if it's not going to happen here, if it doesn't happen here, it ain't going to happen nowhere. Woo! Be working for you, baby.
Oh, get him.
Thank you so much, Bubba.
All right.
Woo!
Oh, beautiful fish. Wow.
That's a peacock right there, buddy.
That's a beautiful fish.
See a hump? That's
a boy. Oh, yeah. Great.
This week's Chevy Destination takes us to sunny Miami, Florida. From the shallow flats of Biscayne Bay to the depths of the Gulf Stream in the Atlantic Ocean, Miami is an angler's paradise. With such diverse ecosystems supported by mangroves, coral reefs, and warm, fast-moving current, Miami's water is teeming with a variety of species that make a delicious dinner or great mount. And if you need a guide for the Florida area, look no further than the team at iOutdoor.com. iOutdoor is an exclusive one-stop shopping for not only Miami, but all bodies of Florida fishing from fresh to saltwater. Visit them online at iOutdoor.com. Your new adventure starts here. And no matter where your next fishing adventure takes you, make sure you're getting there in a new Chevrolet vehicle of your choice. Visit Chevrolet.com for monthly specials and a dealer near you.
South Carolina law prohibits anyone from operating a moving motorized vessel or vessel under sail while under the influence of alcohol, drugs, or a combination thereof. If you must drink, please have a designated driver. Remember, be safe, boat sober.
Have you ever wanted to own a military Humvee of your very own? Well, in sponsorship with GovPlanet, I'm going to make that dream come true. One lucky grand prize winner is going to be selected to own a piece of military history. It's simple. Visit winahumvee.com and register today. It's just that easy.
Don't wait. Register today at winahumvee.com. That's winahumvee.com. GovPlanet, your online auction site for surplus government equipment.
How's it going?
Hi.
Today we're going to be comparing the roll-formed, high-strength steel bed of the Chevy Silverado to the aluminum bed of this competitor's truck.
Awesome.
All right, let him drop. Let's see how the aluminum bed of this truck held up.
Wow. Ooh,
that's a good-sized punch here.
That's all the way through, for sure.
Full-on crack here.
If you're aluminum now, you're going to go, ooh.
Let's check out the Silverado steel bed.
Wow.
Yeah, a couple dents.
I'd expect more dents.
Chevy clearly held up better than the Ford.
Aggressive, modern, and durable. The latest advancement in spinning has the Revo name on it, and almost a century of fishing expertise in it. No matter where your passion takes you, world-class fishing is only a Revo away.
On South Carolina waters, it is very critical to keep a proper lookout when operating a watercraft. Boats do not have turn signals or brake lights, and the operator needs to have a 360-degree radius around him he is observing.
Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine is brought to you by Chevrolet. The official vehicle of Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine. By Pennington Seed. By Pennington Seed. The leader in outdoor forage products. By Browning. The best there is. And by Bienville Plantation, trophy bass and Florida's best quail hunting. By Northside, performance outdoor footwear for the whole family. And by Browning Ammunition, the dawn of a new generation.
I got a bite.
Right, fish get, on, get buddy. Nail him. Get
fish
nail
on.
Up, up, up.
There you go, Bob.
Woo. Hey, we must have hit the hole, Bob.
Yep.
You know, they're hanging right up on the rocks, Roger.
Yep.
Now, tell me about that phenomena.
Well, let me tell you one thing. I mean, this fish are coming from the Amazon. It's,
right.
You know, there's not a whole lot of rocks. It's more like, I think they're looking for structure.
Okay.
And for me, I think the real reason about being hanging on the rocks is just the water got warmer on the rocks.
I got
they
you.
They really like warm water. That's what it is.
I got you.
And they're like smallmouth. They're always going to be, you'll see them in schools. When you catch one, there's going to be more around it, so.
Well, it looked like we caught a litter mates right there. Now.
Yep.
That's awesome.
You got the boy, I got the girl.
Yeah, man.
There you go.
Oh, well, I got to be careful with this treble hook here,
hook.
I can
yep.
tell you. Of course, he will absolutely do a number on me. Ooh.
I like that kind of bait, man. It's working pretty good.
Well, it's a Sebille flat shad. I thought maybe that thing might work up against those rocks like
they
that.
They like it.
You know? Again, throwing Berkeley braid, flat shad by Sebille folks, huh? You're doing the shiner thing.
There
you know,
go.
You got to do that in order to find these fish.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. Sometimes you got to do it. Yep.
There you go. Peacock bass. Folks, that's our destination this week, right down here in beautiful Miami, Florida. Captain Roger Gonzalez right here, iOutdoor.com. This is a great destination this week. Beautiful, beautiful fishery here. They've got over, what, 12 lakes to fish here?
Yep, it's about 12.
Yeah, this is a special kind of a weekend deal.
And actually, then you're fishing. It's a private lake. I got access only on the weekends. And, you know, it's something out of mind in here, buddy. I love it.
And you fish 7 days a week. So, I mean, folks, listen, Roger's got it going on down here. There's a lot more action this week on our show here. Peacock Bass, Florida. It's December, I'm gonna date it. I normally don't do that, but listen, man, I can see Santa Claus. He's getting his sleigh ready, huh?
Oh, yeah.
We're down there fishing in beautiful
Miami,
Florida.
Look at the weather,
man.
There you go. Still warm.
All right, well, let's get back in there and get some more.
Woo-hoo. You got it.
All right.
That's a peacock right there.
Yeah, man. Hot dog.
There you go.
Oh, man.
Look how strong those fish are,
buddy. Brother.
Fighting, fighting.
All right. Man, that's a beautiful fish. Look at him. Woo-hoo, yeah. Hot dog.
Nice.
Man.
Peacock bass.
Wow.
Look at the colors on that one.
Beautiful fish, isn't it? Oh, well, if I can just grab him. All right, man. Come here.
There you go.
Come here. All right. Awesome. We've been looking for you all day.
Yep.
Wow. Awesome. That's what I'm talking about.
Good job, buddy.
Woo-hoo. Thank you, man.
My pleasure, man.
iOutdoor.com, Captain Roger Gonzalez. This is an awesome trip, folks. Largemouth, peacock bass. I'm telling you, you gotta come. You gotta come. Take it, man, take it.
Woo-hoo. Another peacock, buddy. There you go.
Yep. Nice, nice, nice. There you go. Get him, man. Get him over here, not hip you, get him out. I got my union card. Okay, how many years have you been fishing?
Well, I've been fishing since I remember. I was young. I started fishing saltwater in South America and Venezuela.
Yeah.
Then my uncle introduced me to peacock fishing in the Amazon, and I got hooked up since I was real, real young, man.
Really? How many years you been guiding down in Florida?
I said probably 7-8 years.
Wow. Awesome.
And probably 4 or 5 years ago, I got the blessed to join.
iOutdoors.
Yeah. I mean, they give me the opportunity, and
awesome.
Let me tell you one thing. I mean, I feel so blessed working for that family, man.
Well, listen, you are the best, bro.
Thank you, buddy. Appreciate it.
Let's get some more fish, man.
You got it, my
Woo!
Man.
All right.
If you're looking for a new fishing or hunting location that is affordable and with an outfitter you can trust, then visit bobredfern.com and click on Bob's Top 16. Enjoy a day on the water or in the field with the same outfitters we do on the show each and every week. Your next outdoor adventure is just one click away with Bob's Top 16. Northside, performance outdoor footwear for the whole family.
I was really fortunate to be raised in a family with a strong outdoor heritage. We've been farming and hunting land that's been in our family since the Revolutionary War. Being good stewards of the land and wildlife and passing that on to future generations has always been part of our heritage. My grandfather created a company based on these values, and 70 years later, Pennington is still guided by these principles. This culture and these values are reflected in all of our products. Let us help you create your own outdoor legacy.
From bass and walleye to crappie and the great outdoors, you deserve more than old school aluminum. Reward yourself with the quality, performance, and extra room in a Ranger aluminum design. Packed with features, these rigs carry an ultra smooth dry ride and stable platforms. Experience a Ranger aluminum boat today. It's engineered to excel and priced to be yours.
the Sportsman's Table. Brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. Remember, buy South Carolina. It's a matter of taste.
Well, folks, this week we're at the International Culinary Institute here in Myrtle Beach, and joining me is a former graduate, and he is now the proud owner of the Warehouse Restaurant in Conway. Listen, I tell you what, Executive Chef Eston McDowell. Eston, thanks, man.
Appreciate you having me
well,
on.
Well, listen, thank you. You know, I tell you what, it's always great to have former students and now see folks do good. You got some tuna for us this week.
I do.
What do you got?
We're going to do a Taste of Summer salad, and it's kind of becoming one of our staples over the warehouse. And what it is, because it's summertime, we like to do, you know, fresh produce.
Yeah,
and, it's been a lot of fun so far. A lot of people are coming and eating it up. But what we're going to do is we're going to do a cucumber, tomato, and Clemson blue cheese. And what we do is we do a spicy pickle brine slaw that's a red wine pickle brine.
Awesome.
So we're going to do that slaw over top of it and then sear the tuna and put it over top of it.
All right, man. Well, let's get started. I can't wait. All right.
So what we're going to do here.
Layer down. Yeah, there you go. And folks, if you want a copy of Eston's recipe, just log on to bobredfern.com. Click on the Sportsman's Table. It'll be right there.
I like to hit it with a little bit of blackening just to give it that little extra oomph.
Yeah, okay.
We've got some fresh local tomatoes from here.
Always certified SC.
Mm. And what we're going to do is just hit that nicely with some cheese.
Mm. And that's blue cheese, right?
Yes, this is a Clemson blue cheese.
Clemson blue cheese.
Okay. Then what we're going to do now is take a little bit of this slaw and just lay it over the top.
Oh, man, that's awesome. Great colors, too. You know, I know it's about presentation.
It is about presentation, yeah. But I think it's more about that taste. I
well,
like
that,
that crisp
too. You're
crunch
right.
into it. And yeah, it's so good.
I mean, when the waiter brings it out,
that's right.
It's that aha moment. Okay.
Then what we're going to do real quick is just sear this.
Now, minute to each side.
I like to do, actually, we like to serve it mid-wear at the warehouse. So what we do about 35 to 45 seconds on each side.
Right.
Give it a real good, let that blackening sauce get just really good and seared on it.
Okay. And folks, also the blackening sauce that he's referring to is, of course, the rub, as we all know, on the fish. And he'll have that on the recipe as well. Ooh, yeah, look at that. Ooh, and it doesn't take long.
No, it's a very, very quick cook time. Mm. We do encourage you, if you do follow the recipe and cook the pickle brine at your house,
right.
We do encourage you to let it pickle overnight and okay. serve it the next day,
oh,
just to
fine.
Get all that flavor
that's
in there.
That's awesome. This is a quick dish. Man. No wonder folks like it at the restaurant.
That's yeah. right. It does. It comes out very, very quick. What we're going to do is we're just going to cut this real quick.
Okay. All right, Eston, man, we're ready to plate.
Ooh. Yeah, and what we do here, like I said, we really encourage you to kind of get that mid-rare.
Oh, I got you. Yeah.
But what we're going to do is just lay it over top of the salad here.
Mm, great. Mm-mm.
What we like to do is this brine has a really, really good flavor. So what we like to finish it off with is kind of use this as the dressing of the salad itself.
Oh, yeah.
And just hit that spicy brine over top of it. And
now, is this mostly eaten as an entree or before
you know,
dinner?
You know, it's kind of funny. We do a lot of both. We have a lot of customers that really enjoy it as an appetizer.
Awesome.
You know, a lot of the ladies that are coming into the warehouse are really yeah. starting to enjoy it as entrees. You
well,
know, so
and it's fresh.
And it is. It's it as is. Fresh as Absolutely. It gets. And it's so much fun
Thank
to cook.
So, well, the warehouse, congratulations in Conway, Eston. And listen, folks, if you want more great food like this on your visit to Myrtle Beach, log on to CertifiedSCGrown.com and see what's fresh on the menu for yourself. We'll be right back here again next week with another great recipe on the Sportsman's Table.
If you would like more information on South Carolina-grown products, visit them online at CertifiedSCGrown.com. Remember, buy South Carolina. It's a matter of taste.
Buckle.
Hi.
Today we're going to be comparing the roll-formed, high-strength steel bed of the Chevy Silverado to the aluminum bed of this competitor's truck.
Nice.
Want to grab that empty toolbox for me? Let's start here with the aluminum bed.
That's
wow,
a big hole.
Huge.
We got Swiss cheese for a truck here.
I'm curious to see if that will do the same thing with the Chevy.
Well, let's find out. Same spot, same angle, same empty toolbox.
Took it way better.
The steel held up.
Silverado proved it is the toughest truck here.
We were born to innovate, to find a better way. New Berkeley hard baits. New designs. Trigger loaded actions. Mind-blowing colors. Because everyone
wants to catch more fish.
Bienville Plantation is America's number one sportsman's paradise. At Bienville Plantation, sportsmen may choose to follow champion bird dogs while upland bird hunting on some of the best habitat that North Florida can offer. Or you may have the opportunity to land that trophy bass of a lifetime on the numerous lakes that Bienville Plantation has on its property. Bienville also offers luxury accommodations and fine dining for individuals or corporate parties. Bienville Plantation, where we make outdoor dreams come true.
There's a certain pride in knowing our food comes from a place we love, home. And when you consider all our state has to offer, you don't have to go too far to find great tasting food. So the next time you gather around a table, choose certified South Carolina grown, because here at home, it's a matter of taste.
Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine is brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources. Life's better outdoors. And by Ugly Stick GX2, America's strongest, most sensitive rod. By the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. Nothing's fresher, nothing's finer. By Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time. And by GovPlanet, the best place to buy surplus equipment.
Fish, Roger, fish, brother.
You got a fish, buddy?
Yeah, man.
There you go.
All right, bro. Okay, now Roger, tell me what, now we've caught a whole variety of peacock bass and largemouth, okay, and what is the average size? I know they get up, what, 9, 8, 9, 10 pounds?
Well, the state record is about 9 pounds. The average size, especially in this place where we're fishing right now, is about 3 pounds. We do have fish, right. 6, 7, 8 pounders in here. This time of the year, for some reason, they go down deep, and you get about, you know, this time of the year, you get about the average. But in the summertime, buddy, that's when the big ones come up to the shallow water, and you can be able to catch a few big ones in one day.
Well, and listen, I love the variety, too. Yep. I mean, I love peacock. They fight. They're great. I mean, you know, but at least you're catching fish.
Yep.
And you know, gosh, that's what's awesome.
It's an unstop, nonstop action all day long.
That's it.
Yep.
There you go, man.
That's what I like about this place.
I'm telling you, it's beautiful. It is absolutely beautiful. Folks, again, ioutdoor.com, Captain Roger G, man.
Thank you so much, brother.
All right, man, let's do it
again. Appreciate it. You got it, buddy.
Well, folks, joining me now is Todd Kersey. He's the CEO of the Florida Fishing Network. And I tell you what, you know, Todd, listen, a big thank you to you.
Oh, are you kidding?
You have got just a terrific organization here and just a conglomerate of guides out of this world.
Well, it means a lot coming from you, for sure. But, yeah, you know, we've just been able over the years to really find the proper people for the proper jobs. And I think what we've got here is a conglomerate of people that love fishing. And that's really where it starts.
Well, you know, okay, let's talk about the fishing network. I know you've got bassonline.com, yeah. You've got iOutdoor. I mean, tell us about all that. You've got freshwater, you've got saltwater.
Certainly.
I mean, you go the full gamut.
Absolutely. We go offshore, inshore, bass fishing. So when we started, we got into the freshwater because that was kind of our niche, you know. And we got bassonline.com, which become a great brand for Florida. We're in 364 locations in Florida, just in bass fishing. And then we created the iOutdoor and some of the other saltwater brands to really venture out because guys in that industry were reaching out to us. And amongst that, we said, well, we're reaping the reward from these fisheries. We're making huge impacts in destinations. So we created a non-for-profit. We just did a bunch of things for the fisheries. So I believe if you're going to make the money, you got to be able to get back.
Well, I mean, again, finding good guides is a key because, again, all the tourism that comes to Florida to fish, folks that fish look you up, okay, because they want to get connected with your guides because, again,
yeah.
Unless you're on fish all the time, I don't care who you are, okay,
yeah.
And like our show today here, Peacock Bass Fishing, gosh, I mean, it's just awesome. I mean, Roger, and then also I know you go into the Everglades, which yeah. is just another adventure in itself. Talk to me about some of the different aspects of it.
Absolutely. So, you know, the Everglades is unique because it's a federal national park, you know, I mean, birds, and it's the only place where alligators and crocodiles exist, you know. Florida has such a gamma, you know, from Naples with white beaches to Fort Lauderdale where you got, you know, nightclubs and great fishing, and sail fishing is phenomenal. You go down to Miami, the sword fishing, the sea trout, the redfish. You know, Florida's just got it all. I mean, we go to Daytona and you got bull reds and freaking 10, 12 pound bass in Orlando.
Wow.
And, you know, it's just so cool. You can go to Suwannee River and catch Suwannee bass. It's just a cool state. And so, you know, hey, today we're here with the peacock bass. It was something that the state brought in. It's been a fantastic asset for the state of Florida. And we're very blessed to have it and very blessed to have a guy like Captain Rogers. He loves his job.
Well, he does. And, you know, one other final thing I want to talk about is let's talk about how to get connected with a guide, okay, because it's real easy. I mean, you don't, Absolutely. You know, the thing about it is I know I love guides, okay, but, Yeah. You know, when they run their own business, they're usually out on a trip, they're answering the phone, they're trying That's to right. coordinate while other guests are on the boat. You guys have taken care of all that. They don't even have, all they got to do is fish and put their guests on fish.
Yeah, there's two things you touched on there, really, is that one, the customer wants their attention, right?
Yeah. I mean,
that's what they're paying
exactly.
for. That's what they deserve. And then we want quality guys that are actually going to go out there and stay on the fish. And more importantly, by being a single guide, how many lakes can you fish? How many spots can you stay on? You're always fishing yesterday's history fishing, right?
Exactly.
When you can have multiple guides in one location and they're all working as a team, every guide's going to have a bad day. We just have less of them.
You bet. Well, Todd, listen, we hope you have us back, man. Hey, we'll have to come back.
It was a pleasure to have you.
We'll come back, maybe do some more salt water, do some more fresh water. Listen,
absolutely.
And we love this organization, okay? And folks, there you have it from Todd Kersey, the Florida Fishing Network.
Muy grande.
Ah, I think you're right, bro.
Grande.
You know, there's been kind of a difference here. It's got a little warmer.
Yep.
The sun's out.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
That's what they like, man.
And I'll tell you what, that Berkeley Nanofill really handles those fish.
They like the warm water.
Yeah, man. Look at that.
Work it up, baby. Work it up.
Mm-hmm. Ah, come on. Come on.
Man, I like your rig, man.
Ah. Oh, yeah, that's a peacock. Nice.
Oh, that's a pretty one, buddy.
Nice. Nice right there, Roger.
There you go.
Look at that.
Look at the colors
on
that fish.
Oh, yeah, look at him.
Woo!
Look at that.
Whoa, let me help you out here, bub.
Oh,
easy,
yeah, that
baby.
Is awesome.
Easy.
That is awesome.
Easy, baby, let me help you out.
All right.
Hey, you go look you at the him? Orange in this fish,
oh,
buddy.
Oh, look at him. Ooh, yeah.
There you go. Mm-mm. Good job, bub.
Wow. Well, folks, listen, I've had a great trip down here. Hope you all have. Joining us down here in Miami, Florida, Captain Roger Gonzalez, iOutdoor.com. This guy is awesome, okay? The only thing I can tell you is, Bo, they don't get no better than this.
Oh, I'm telling you, buddy.
Listen, that is a beautiful fish. Peacock bass, you want to come down here and fish with this guy? Listen, you need to log on to Bob's Top 16 or go to iOutdoor.com and you too can come down here and have a day on the water, 2 days, whatever you want. And I listen, thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Yeah. I appreciate it.
All right, man. Listen, as I always like to say each and every week, the outdoors is my passion. I want it to be yours too. We'll see you next time. Hi,
see you
Roger.
Guys. Woohoo!